name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Elizabeth died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. That your Son died and rose again, mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Elizabeth, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book, the prophet Isaiah. Excuse me. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples. The web that is woven over all nations, he will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, the reproach of his people. He will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we look. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
The Lord is my Lord.
Romans 6:3-9. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Are you not aware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Through baptism into death, we were buried with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. If we have been united with him through likeness to his death, so shall we be through resurrection. This we know, our old self was crucified with him, so that the sinful body might be destroyed and we might be slaves to sin no longer. A man who is dead has been freed from sin. If we have died with Christ, we believe that we are also to live with him. We know that Christ, once raised from the dead, will never die again. Death has no more power over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon. And at 3 o'clock, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani," which is translated, my God, why have you forsaken me?" Some of the bystanders who heard it said, "Look, he is calling Elijah." One of them ran, soaked a sponge with wine, put it on a reed, and gave it to him to drink, saying, "Wait, let us see if Elijah comes to take him down." Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. The veil of the sanctuary was torn in two from top to bottom. When the centurion who stood facing him saw how he breathed his last, he said, "Truly, this man was the Son of God." When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome brought spices so that they might go and anoint him. Very early, when the sun had risen on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb. They were saying to one another, "Who will roll back the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled back. It was very large. On entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in a white robe, and they were utterly amazed. He said to them, "Do not be amazed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, the crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Behold the place where they laid him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord, It was for 100 years in the top 25 in rank. And it was the only one that was top 10 from 1925 to 1972, about 47 years. What was it? It was the name Elizabeth. It was very popular. And Elizabeth means pledged to God, or God's oath. Elizabeth was born November 5th, 1928, 92 years ago. And that's a good number. Elizabeth was born November 5th, which was a Monday. And on that day, November 5th, in the church calendar, we celebrate a very special saint. I don't know if you know her name. You might have heard. November 5th is the feast day of Saint Elizabeth. It's beautiful. And Saint Elizabeth was the mother of John the Baptist. Saint Elizabeth and her baby in her womb all pointed to Jesus Christ. I was told just a few minutes ago when I met Martha for the first time that she said her mother was very religious, and to be religious means to have Jesus, to be close to the Lord. She takes after her namesake. When Elizabeth died, it was February 28, which was a Sunday. On that day, there was a special saint in our church calendar. That saint is Saint Hilary, who was a bishop and one of the few doctors in our church. A doctor is declared a doctor for the teachings that they have and the writings that they have to draw us closer to the Lord. And Saint Hilary's is known to defend the church against heresy. At the time that Saint Hilary was alive, there was a very strong heresy, which was called Arianism. And Arianism came up because people had certain questions. The questions were, how can God be human? God be a human? How can God take on human form and human life? How can God die? God, how can God die? These were the questions that they were struggling with. And can God die at all and remain God? For some people, they said to these questions, no, God cannot die. God can't take human form. God can't take a human life. So they said, Jesus, that man was only a man. He was only human. He was not divine. But that we know is an error. Jesus is human and divine. We say he was made incarnate. The divinity merged with humanity. And Saint Hilary defended that. He defended the faith. He defended Jesus Christ as being both God and man, both human and divine. Today, March 5th, there's a special saint in the calendar also. His name is Saint John Joseph of the Cross. He was born in an island close to Naples in Italy. And Saint John Joseph of the Cross was so close to the Lord, he was blessed with special gifts. They said when he would pray, he would be so absorbed in prayer that they would find him levitating. They He was given the gift of bilocation. He could be in two places at the same time, helping two people at the same time. He had the gift of prophecy and also performed many miracles. There are so many stories, but there was a story of a man, a father who came to, at that time, just the priest, Father John Joseph, and the father begged Father John Joseph to help his son, his five-year-old son. He said, "My son is very sick and he's dying. Please help." And Father John Joseph said, "I don't think that's a good idea." He had the gift of prophecy. And he said to the father, "Let him go." And the father said, "No, I only had two children and my daughter died. I want one for God and one for me. My son is left. Please help my son." And Father John Joseph said, "That's really not a good idea." And the father said, "Please." So John Joseph said, "Okay." The son got well. A year later, the father, same father, came back to John Joseph and said, "I think I'm ready to let my son go." And the priest said to him, "I told you." And the father said, "He doesn't seem happy." And Father John Joseph said, "No, he has been prevented from being with the Lord for a year so far to be with you. Are you ready to let him go?" And the father said, "Yes." The little boy smiled and the father looked at the boy and said, "That's the first time he smiled in a year." And the kid died shortly after. Yet, Father John Joseph, Saint John Joseph of the Cross, had the gift of prophecy and miracles. All of this happens because of Jesus Christ, God and man. We are here during this time of Lent when we are heading towards Easter, where the gospel reminds us that the tomb where they put Jesus, the God and man, was found empty. He rose from the dead. This is what we can cling to, that we have Jesus who helps us and Jesus who destroys death. He gives us great hope. We are here to pray. We are here with hope, especially with Elizabeth's body present, knowing that death is not the end, that there is God. Pope Benedict XVI wrote on many occasions and also mentioned many times, God came into our life, he showed us his face, and his name is Jesus. Jesus rose from the dead. He destroyed death. He gives us great hope. We pray that Elizabeth rests in peace. God bless you. Let us, in faith, call upon God the Almighty Father, who raised Christ his Son from the dead, as we pray for the salvation of the living and the dead.
The response is, hear our prayer.
Hear our prayer.
For Elizabeth, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all of our beloved deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, in your mercy, for those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face. Lord, in your mercy. For the family and friends of our sister Elizabeth, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend, Lazarus. Lord, in your mercy.
May the prayer of those who cry to you benefit the souls of your servants, O Lord. Free them, we pray, from all their sins, and make them sharers in your redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Elizabeth may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Father of mercies, we commend our sister Elizabeth in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Elizabeth in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.